I'm Stephen Malitz, and this is the Entrepreneur Advisor. Here's a great question. I've been sued for fraud. What is it, and how do I defend against the claim? First, what is fraud? Fraud is an intentional misstatement of material present fact made by the fraudster to induce reliance by the listener. The listener relies on the fraud and is damaged as a result. Lot to unpack there. Let's break it down. Let's parse the elements of a fraud claim. Fraud must be an intentional misstatement. That's to be distinguished from negligence. If you're driving down the street and you accidentally crash into somebody, that's negligent. You had no intentional mental state. It's just an accident. Fraud must be you intend to deceive someone. Fraud must be an intentional misstatement of material present fact, not opinion. Well, let's say you go into a car dealership and you want a really fast car. And you tell the salesman, I want a fast car. And the salesman understands exactly what you're saying. The salesman sells you a Yugo, and it's very slow. And you leave the dealership and you're displeased. Can you sue the dealership for fraud? The answer is no. Because what is fast to you might not be fast to the salesman, might not be fast to your grandmother, might not be fast to a professional car driver. It is not a misstatement of fact. It might be a misstatement of opinion, and an opinion is not actionable fraud. Your buddy has a business. He says to you, Malitz, will you come along and invest $100,000 in my business? The business is doing okay, but in the next 3 years, it's going to explode. We're gonna make a ton of money on it. You rely on what your buddy says. You invest the $100,000 and the business doesn't last at all and it dies. Can you sue your friend for fraud? The answer is generally no. Because all your friend did was predict a future event, that the business would do well. That is not a misstatement of present fact. It's a prediction. It's not actionable fraud. You go to buy a house. You're a dentist. You have a great practice already, but you want to buy a house in a subdivision next to a bunch of other houses and put another dental practice in there. You say to your seller, seller, can I put my dental practice in here? Seller says, absolutely. Buy my house, put the practice in, it will thrive based on all your neighbors. You buy the house, you put your practice in, you put the oxygen in, you put the x-ray. As soon as you set up your practice on day one, the city comes in and shuts you down for violation of the zoning laws. Is that fraud? No, because all your seller did was misstate the law as opposed to misstate the facts. And anyone is equally capable of discerning the law, meaning ignorance of the law is no excuse. It's not fraud. Next, there must be reliance on the fraudulent statement. If you're gonna buy a house and you say to your seller, is there water damage and is there termite damage? And the seller says, no, the house is pristine. And you walk through the house and you could see there's termite damage, you could see there's water damage, but you close anyway. Can you sue your seller for fraud? No, because you could not reasonably rely on your seller's misrepresentations. You could see the defects in the house with your naked eye. Finally, for you to recover for fraud, there must be damages. You buy a box of candy. The right number of candies are in there, but the box looks like it's empty. You bring the candy to your ma, she opens the box, the candy's there, but there's a lot of space. You sue the candy manufacturer for fraud. Is it fraud? Well, the outside of the box says that there's supposed to be 10 candies in the box, and there are. And the box says the net weight of the candy is supposed to be 5 ounces, and it is. Therefore, even though there's space in the box, you've sustained no monetary damages, so there is no fraud claim. Here's an example of what fraud is. You're in business with your partner. You own a restaurant together, a sushi restaurant. All of the assets of the restaurant are joint because you're partners. If your partner borrows employees and takes the restaurant goods in the sushi and he does private catering events and doesn't tell you he is doing so, he's concealing from you that he is pilfering company assets. That's an example of fraud. We have covered the elements of fraud. Even though it may seem that you don't have a defense, it is key in these cases to parse the elements of the cause of action to see whether it even meets the standards of fraud. Don't lay down, get help in these cases. If you have any questions about fraud and how to defend it, please let me know. Thank you. If you have found this material useful and entertaining, please share it, subscribe to the channel, and ring the bell for notifications of future episodes. Also, please take a look at the playlist for prior episodes. Thank you for watching The Entrepreneur Advisor.